Let me tell you the broad units. So unit one is just an introduction. So I am sure that unit one, primarily chapter one of this book, will not be difficult because it is just talking about very, very basic things. Then unit two is on functions of one variable. So we will be talking about functions of one real variable. What are the different concepts related to it? Why are they useful specifically in economics? And what are the kind of conclusions that we can derive? Specifically, what are the conclusions that we can derive about functions that we use in economics? Because this is not just mathematics. Jo aapne school mein padha hai, that is just mathematics. But this is mathematics for economic analysis. So you will eventually realize when we move on with the syllabus that the things, the concepts that you are reading here, there are two aspects to these concepts. One is the mathematical aspect, which is what you would have done in your class 12th and class 11th, which is just talking about maths. But the second aspect of the concepts in this book, in this subject, is on economic analysis. So whenever we are dealing with mathematical concepts in this paper, you will simultaneously try to understand the application of such concepts in the economic field. The concepts that we deal here in this paper will be useful to understand, to analyze the other economic papers. So to be able to understand microeconomic theory, you really need to be well versed with the mathematical aspect behind it. So this subject will help you, it is like the backbone of the entire field of economics, because it helps you understand the other theories in a better way. So mathematics is extremely important as an economics student. That is the first thing that you should be, confident in, and you should be able to understand mathematics from its very foundational state. So by that I mean that you would have read a lot of things, a lot of formulas, a lot of concepts already. When I start with the chapters, you will realize that these are things that we have already studied. But you are definitely going to read these concepts in a slightly different manner, because we will be learning the concepts. I mean, we'll be learning each concept from the scratch, and that will help you understand the subject better. Both it will clarify your mathematical question, as well as it will help you understand economic subject better. Yeah, so we'll be dealing with functions of one real variables in unit two, and unit three is on optimization. Since we are only dealing with functions of one variable in this semester, we will be dealing with single variable optimization. Now, optimization, why are we focusing on optimization, is because economics as a subject is a subject of optimization. Very fundamental aspect is the understanding of how do we sustain or satisfy unlimited wants in the presence of scarce resources. This is the first thing that you would have read when you started reading economics, which is that we know in a given economy there is a problem of scarcity of resources, which is that we do not have unlimited resources, right? But we have unlimited wants. If suppose I tell you, you are the person controlling Indian economy and you want to make the economy the best economy in the world, do you have a cap that once I reach, once my country's GDP reaches a certain billion, million benchmark, that is when I will stop? No, you would always, even when you become the best economy in the world, you would still not, you will not stop growing. You will still continue to grow. So there is no benchmark to growth. There is no limit to growth. You will have unlimited wants as an economy, as an individual. If I talk about your personal growth, if I tell you that, if I ask you, how do you define growth? then it is unlimited. As humans, as individuals, as economic agents, we have unlimited wants. Even when you become the richest person in the world, you still are not satisfied. So we, as human, as economic agents, you know, the economy is made up of all these small individuals. Microeconomics में आप क्या बात करते हो? Microeconomics में you are talking at an individual level. कि what does an individual consumer do? How would an individual firm behave? But when you add all of these individuals, you get the entire economy, right? And this is the entire economy that we are trying to understand. But we know that whether you talk about individual agents or you talk about the economy as a whole, this problem of unlimited wants is present in both the situations. But we cannot satisfy these unlimited wants because of the issue of scarcity of resources. If you intend to become the richest person in the world, you can still become richest to a certain level. You cannot cross that level. Suppose your economy has a total money of 100 rupees, hypothetically, it's obviously not true. Your economy is worth 100 rupees and you want to become the richest person in the economy and you are aiming for something more than rupees 100. That is not possible. So obviously, your wants have to be in coherence with the amount of resources that we have in the economy. So how do we understand this is what economics is all about. Economics is a study of identifying the best use of these resources, which is, in other words, in a more technical language, it is called as optimization. Optimization tells you the best possible solution of the wants in the presence of scarcity of resources. Jitne bhi resources aapke paas available hain aur jo bhi aapka want hai, usko aap kitna maximum possible point attain kar sakte ho in the presence of scarcity of resources is the science of optimization, and that is why optimization is very, very crucial in economics. If I give you a simple problem, if I talk about a consumer, what does a consumer really want? Suppose a consumer has a utility for sweets. Okay? There is a consumer who is craving desserts, is craving sweet food objects. Okay, so the consumer has an unlimited want for the sweet food products. But what is the constraint? And you know, the consumer goes to say a bakery and has many available options, you know, and the consumer is craving for dessert so much that the consumer, if given an opportunity, would want to eat all the cakes available in this bakery. But is that possible? No. Why? Because the consumer has a scarcity of resource, which is the budget. Obviously, to purchase the entire set of cakes in this bakery, you will need to have a lot of money, and that may not be possible for a given consumer. So the budget is the scarce resource that we are talking about here in this specific situation. And the unlimited want is the want for desserts. Yeah. So in this situation, how do we find the answer? We, as a consumer, I want to sustain my craving. I want to satisfy my craving for desserts. And I also know that I only have a limited amount of resources, a limited amount of budget, limited amount of money. How can I find a point which is a point that gives me the maximum satisfaction possible given the amount of money that I have? So say I have 100 rupees with me. What is the maximum amount of sweetness that I can have from the available options in the bakery is what optimization tells you. So optimization will give you answers for the best possible points in the presence of scarce resources. So in unit 3, we are going to understand single variable optimization, and I have just told you why this is so important in economics, because economics is essentially a study of optimization. And the last unit then is on linear algebra. So these are the 4 units that you have for this semester. Preliminaries, basic things about mathematics, so that you are able to understand the following 3 units. Unit 2, functions of unreal variables. Unit 3, single variable optimization. And the last is linear algebra. Okay. I will tell you the chapters within these units. Chapter 1 to 9 and 12 to 14. In sare chapters mein aapke ye charo units cover ho jayenge. This is the book, which is Mathematics for Economic Analysis by Sid Satter and Hammond. This is a soft copy of the book. And this is your main textbook for this subject.